In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Show us, O Lord, your mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Kyrie. God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the book of Genesis. Taking Abram outside, the Lord said, "Look up to heaven and count the stars if you can. Such will be your descendants," he told him. Abram put his faith in the Lord, who counted this as making him justified. "I am the Lord," he said to him, "who brought you out of Ur of the Chaldeans, to make you heir to this land." "My Lord, the Lord," Abram replied, "how am I to know that I shall inherit it?" And he said to him, "Get me a 3-year-old heifer, a 3-year-old goat, a 3-year-old ram, a turtle dove, and a young pigeon." He brought him all these, cut them in half, and put half on one side and half facing it on the other. But the birds he did not cut in half. Birds of prey came down on the ground. When the sun had set and darkness had fallen, there appeared a smoking furnace and a firebrand that went between the halves. That day the Lord made a covenant with Abram in these terms: "To your descendants I give this land, from the Wadi of Egypt to the great river." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. My brothers, be united in following my rule of life. Take as your models everybody who is already doing this, and study them as you used to study us. I have told you often, and I repeat it today with tears, there are many who are behaving as the enemies of the cross of Christ. They are destined to be lost. They make foods into their God, and they are proudest of something they ought to think shameful. The things they think important are earthly things. For us, our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Saviour we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ, and he will transfigure these wretched bodies of ours into copies of his glorious body. He will do that by the same power with which he can subdue the whole universe. So then, my brothers and dear friends, do not give way, but remain faithful in the Lord. I miss you very much, dear friends. You are my joy and my crown. The word of the Lord. From the bright cloud, the Father's voice was heard. This is my Son, the Beloved. Listen to him.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus took with him Peter and John and James and went up the mountain to pray. As he prayed, the aspect of his face was changed, and his clothing became brilliant as lightning. Suddenly, there were two men there talking to him. They were Moses and Elijah, appearing in glory. And they were speaking of his passing, which he was to accomplish in Jerusalem. Peter and his companions were heavy with sleep, but they kept awake and saw his glory and the two men standing with him. As these were leaving him, Peter said to Jesus, Master, it is wonderful for us to be here. So let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He did not know what he was saying. As he spoke, a cloud came and covered them with shadow. And when they went into the cloud, the disciples were afraid. And a voice came from the cloud saying, This is my Son, the Chosen One. Listen to him. And after the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone. the disciples kept silence and at that time told no one what they had seen. The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the Gospel story of the Transfiguration, Jesus goes up the mountain to pray, and as he prayed, he was transfigured. His face changed and his whole appearance became radiant with heavenly light. We heard all about it. And for a few precious minutes, it was confirmed to Peter, James, and John that there was something very special about this man whom they had left everything to follow. Something of God that shone through him, especially as he prayed. Now, for us, there's a huge difference between praying and saying prayers. We all could pray more, but it's much more important to pray better than to pray more. And here I suggest a few ways we can pray better and so be transfigured and changed by the light and the love of God. Our first task in prayer is to listen to the Spirit of God. Hear the words of the Father in the Gospel today. This is my Son, the chosen one. Listen to him. So before God asks us to do anything, he asks us to listen. Not just with our ears, but in the words of St. Benedict, with the ears of the heart. Sometimes we are in such a rush to speak to the Lord that we do not take the time to listen first. One of the most basic human needs we have is to understand and to be understood. And nowhere is this more true than in our relationship with God. May we begin every time of quiet prayer with the words of Samuel. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. The second task of prayer is to thank. We thank God for his love, for our lives, for our family, for our health and well-being, for all the things that we have been blessed with. To be Christian is to be grateful and to give thanks. And that's what the Eucharist means, to give thanks. Giving thanks expands the heart and makes us see the good around us before the bad. And think how often Jesus blesses and thanks the Father in the Gospels. And with him, we do the same. The third part of prayer is often thought to be the only part of prayer, namely to ask. We're all tempted to have a false image of God, who is like a big pleaser. If we ask him nicely, we want him to help us, to console us, make things work out as we want, to bless our plans that we have already made. To put it another way, the mistake is we want God to get into our world before we get into his. Yes, Jesus did tell us to ask and we shall receive. And so prayer of intercession is important. But as we mature, we learn to pray for things outside of ourselves, for world peace, already at this moment in peril due to the invasion of Ukraine. For those who are hungry and those who are homeless, wherever they may be, and for those who need help the most, in any shape or form. And the final part of prayer is praise. That's what we have the choir for. To praise God is to go further than thanking Him. It is to fall on our knees to joyfully adore Him as the highest source of love and goodness that there is. It is to worship Him as our loving Father who knows us and loves us through and through. In the words of Scripture, "Worthy are you, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being." Amen. We stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, in the name of Jesus, who is transfigured while at prayer, let us offer our intercessions for ourselves and for the world.
For our church, that we may always listen to God's chosen Son, faithful to the law, the prophets, and the Saviour. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For the catechumens and candidates of our diocese and parish, may they listen to the voice of God's beloved Son and share in the blessings promised to Abraham. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For all those affected by the fighting in Ukraine, for those who have lost lives, loved ones, and homes. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For our parish community of Drumcree, may we be strengthened in our Lenten journey to a true conversion of heart. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who have died, the recently deceased, Bridie Comack of Coal Island, Geordie Craney, Graham Bird, Helen Dolan, Dr. Barry Bradley of Portadown, formerly of OMA, Peter Gorman, and Marcelina da Silva Boavida. At this time, we remember Rita Carroll, Clara Pereira Ribeiro, Gabrielle de Rosa, Katerina Borges, Yuriko Samao, and Irene Gutierrez. And today, the anniversaries of Mary McCarthy, Joseph and Annie McGlade, Kathleen Bennett, John James Jordan, Paddy McCaffrey, and Catherine McKeever. And tomorrow, the anniversaries of David Henry Henderson, James Lappin, Sarah Reynolds, and Detito Corte Real. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Loving God, you clothed your Son Jesus in transfigured glory. Listen to our prayers that one day we might also share in that same glory through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death on the holy mountain, he manifested them his glory to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on her sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And we take a moment to pray in the silence of our heart for peace in Ukraine and for all who are affected by the absence of that peace. Lamb of God, amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let's pray. As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us while still on earth to be partakers even now of the things of heaven through Christ our Lord. Now, just take a wee look at whatever notices there may be. Last week's offertory collection was £1,672.27. The standing order for the month, £907. And thank you to all who contributed. There's some details regarding relaxation of restrictions. I think you're already familiar with them, but you can read them in the bulletin anyhow. The Stations of the Cross will be prayed every Sunday evening during Lent here in St. John the Baptist at 6 p.m. And our Deacon Eunan McCreesh will be leading that. Canon Benny Fee from Clonoe will speak at next weekend's Vigil Mass and at the 8:30 Mass in St. John the Baptist Church, also the 10 o'clock Mass in St. Patrick's, about his recently published In His Master's Footsteps, The Way of the Cross, The Stations of the Cross in the Company of St. Oliver Plunkett. Mass in St. John the Baptist College each weekday morning during Lent at 8 a.m. And after the Friday evening Mass here, the 7 p.m. Mass, the Knights of Columbanus will lead us for a half an hour in prayer and reflection for Lent. And more importantly, St. Patrick's Day, the Masses, the Vigil Mass will be here in St. John the Baptist at 7 p.m. On the 17th of March, Mass will be at 10 a.m. in St. Patrick's and 11:30 here in St. John the Baptist, which will be Osceola. And there'll be a collection at all Masses for the Irish immigrants abroad. That's a blue envelope. The Lord be with you. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever, and keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that we may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty he showed in his own body to the amazement of his apostles, through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. The Mass is ended.